Okay, so this is going to be a very small talk on circumventing internet shutdowns, not fully, not gaining access to, fiber type speeds when the internet's been shut off, but having basic ability for communication when the internet's not working. A lot of these methods, I mean, there's four methods in this talk. They are theoretical, they may not work always. They have worked in the past, or they're surmised to work, but you should test it out and not take it as fact. There's obviously consequences of using any of these methods. You may be detected and given the sort of socio-political realities of where we're living that may cause problems for you. Okay. I gave away the third slide, but is anyone familiar with IPOAC? It's the RFC is 1149. It's basically IP over pigeon. Bad joke, but right. So to get to actual methods, in 2011, when the Arab Spring uprising was happening in Egypt, a group known as Telecomix actually released, dial-up credentials out of, I believe, some other country, but not obviously not Egypt, which people were reportedly able to use to bypass, the internet blockade there. This is the message that they had shared. I think the country code is for Sweden. I may be wrong, but yeah. So this is one very quick method to bypass when broadband or data services have been shut down. But limitations are, you can be surveilled on by the government or by the service provider, and it's very slow, and it could also be disabled. The next one is for when you need to share information when this, internet is blocked using social media. So Twitter and Facebook provide fairly easy methods for doing this. You have two phone numbers which you can message and start sharing content if SMS services are available. Again, if SMS services are shut down, as what happened in Delhi some time ago, when Airtel, Idea, and Jio shut down SMS services as well, you will not be able to use this. Also, if you're sending SMS messages, they can be detected by your DSP. SMS to web, this is not a very straightaway implementable sort of solution. You would have to work on this, but you can sort of build SMS to web gateways which can allow users to do things where if they don't have internet access, they can't do. One example of this, the SMS-based messaging board, a few people had set up this website called Speak India, which basically uses SMS gateway API, and upon receiving an SMS text, it publishes it to a Google Sheet, so people can read messages coming in from people who don't have access to the internet. Other functionality you can set up is using SMTP. You can do SMS to email with very basic communication capabilities. You can just send a message saying that this phone number tried to get in contact with you. SMS for fetching text from web pages, so you can send an SMS, provide a URL, and get the text of the web page back, and also for getting news articles. Again, the limitations are that you can be surveilled on with this method still, and by multiple parties. In fact, the SMS gateway provider, the telecom service provider, and the government, of course, because they can force the telecom provider's hand. Last method here is if you noticed in the when the shutdown happened in Delhi, only a few major providers had shut down access to the services, which were Jio, Airtel, and Vodafone/Idea, which has led me to surmise that if there's a telecom service provider which is not large enough to be in the eyes of the state, where they wouldn't necessarily ask them to shut down access to services, you could potentially use their services and still access the internet. And that's it.